On recording now.
Dude. Unless you did know Max, I probably don't see a way to put you in, but I'll check your background again.
Oh wait, Mike Hill. Oh, never mind. I forgot the comm link got destroyed. I was saying I could have traced back the other guys from being associates with the guy with the elf who raised me. And I just would have ended up tracking one of them down.
You know that fire you know that I'm gonna say you've done a few jobs with Matt you for Max before.
Okay.
So you free get a call and it's from Max.
Okay.
Hey, I want you guys to meet me somewhere. I got a job for you guys.
I see.
It's a well-paying job, and if you're looking forward to seeing things explode, this might be it. I'll give you the address in case you do want to come. And he gives you an address.
And he sends this to all of us, or like he's calling us.
He sends it to you free. Manga, he actually contacts you talking. Hey,
Yeah.
Rogoff, I have another job for you.
Okay.
I'm probably gonna want you to meet me somewhere. But see if you
Fine.
can see if you can try to avoid Firewatch. I think I saw some earlier today.
All right.
You sure you don't want to use that safe house I have?
Yeah, not really. Not for now.
All right.
It's not like they're out to kill me.
All right, so who's actually going to show up?
Why wouldn't I show up?
I'm talking to Jake and Tima since they're not responding.
Didn't he just give us an address? He didn't give us a time, did he?
He said come between he said to come at 6.
And what time is it now?
It's 2 o'clock.
Okay.
Was already closed.
Did he? He didn't specify. Oh, no, shit, I'm dead. He didn't specify what to bring, so I'm assuming it's just a meeting. So I'll just go or try to arrive at 6 best I can.
All right. And I'm assuming everyone else is going to try to arrive at 6. Manga, he did tell you 6, by the way.
I'm gonna
6
be
in the
nearby.
location.
Okay, I'm going to probably show up with an invisibility spell on. I'm not really serious about it. Do you actually want me to roll it or not?
Yeah. You have a sustaining for that illusion?
I'm not gonna bother. I'm gonna end up turning it off by the time we get there. But no, I don't have the sustaining.
All right.
I can just personally sustain it, but
I'm going to be there by 5. Hard to cross the
I'm doing
street
it
in a
for
few.
role-playing purposes, the reason why I'm turning on invisibility.
All right. If this was actually during the actual run, I'd probably have you actually roll, but since this is
Yeah.
role-playing purposes, sure, go ahead.
I'm going to be parked across the street by 5 o'clock, wait an hour watching the place, and my car is going to be blue.
All right.
I'm going to scramble my license plate to say 74283.
All right.
I show up 5:30, by the way.
5:30.
Where are we meeting?
You're going to try to get into the warehouse.
A warehouse. Okay.
Yeah, that's going to be a warehouse. Surprisingly, not anywhere near the docks. Surprisingly, it's still near the docks, but it's not. It seems a little far. It seems to be another part of the docks. Not the part of the docks where you last met. Where you met, some of you met Max.
Oh, it's a warehouse?
Yeah.
I want to get the floor plans of the place.
Alright. Looks like a simple. You could probably get those easily. Since they're basically generic.
I mean, like, say if this one's. So I can basically get into AR and have it loaded up so I know where the fuck I'm going.
Alright. You get it. Yeah, all right. It looks like the normal warehouse is in the area, so you're able to get easily.
Okay.
Were you supposed to meet inside or outside?
Inside.
Did I notice any doors where people are passing through?
There seems to be places where it opens up in both places, but those are technically garage doors. Oh, it opens up on one side. I was reading my notes wrong. It opens up on one side, the back side, not the one facing the street, surprisingly. But there's a door on the side which you can open up and get in.
I was just asking if people were passing through them or not.
Every once in a while, you'll depending on when you get there, like one or two times, you do see someone go in.
You through do the see side door, not the big door, right?
Through the side door, yeah. For the big door, it looks like they finished up a shipment when you get there.
Okay.
And if Jay got there early, he'd probably see that too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I go to the side door and I just hang out there and I'm going to wait for someone either to probably coming out or going in, and I'm probably just going to go. I'm going to end up going in with them or after they come out, maybe.
All right. You do. You see someone opening the door to go outside.
Okay.
So you're going to take that opportunity to sneak in?
Give me a sec. Yeah.
I'm tempted to have you roll infiltration. I'm tempted.
Oh, no, that's fine. Let's see. Seven.
That'd be six. Three, four, five, six.
Seven minus. Oh, wait, I'm sustaining. That's right. Fuck. Okay. That still works. There we go. No hit.
What? Oh.
Thankfully, because you're sustaining that spell, they don't see you, but they do hear something. You hear what sounds like Max go, "What the fuck was that?"
Yep, that's fine.
You know what? I'm gonna try
But you did get in.
I'm gonna try infiltrating as well.
When you get there, you're gonna try infiltrating?
Well,
go ahead, try infiltrating.
Infiltrate?
I'll warn you, actually, since Max probably doesn't know you enough, so if Tima tried to do that, he'd probably get blown away. He's an elf, remember that.
Okay, well, I have...
Fuck you, Max.
I have human fucking
meaning. I know Max is an elf hater, so I will be chill.
Let's see, infiltration.
He's okay with you. He doesn't necessarily hate you, but...
I'm now going to try to position myself kind of behind Max,
currently
leaning up against the wall.
Yeah, you're okay with Max currently. Okay. I forgot that.
The chameleon suit adds 4 to my infiltration.
Yeah. No, it minuses 4 from people's dice.
Oh, you almost got a... You almost got... Actually, if you got would have gotten all 6, that would have been a critical hit.
What are you talking about?
You almost got, like, a good amount of hits.
I got 3 hits. That was pretty good.
Yeah, what? But,
yeah,
and that was for me to sneak up. That was just for me to be positioned behind Max, but I'm leaning against a wall or something.
Okay. You do that. You see his guard just look around the area. Nah, you hear one of them say, nah, I don't see anything. You sure? It's probably just the door, Max.
96. There's my infiltration roll.
1, 2, 3.
Really?
How are you trying to get in? This way I know if you're succeeding or failing.
Well, I'm gonna... Let's see, it's a warehouse. So, I'm basically gonna just... going through a window where no one is looking, or...
You go through a window. When you open the window, one of the guards swear he saw something. He heard something. You open the window, you go down. One of the guards swore you heard something.
Oh. Okay.
Which means now they're even more suspicious.
Well, since the guards heard something after I do, I'd switch to thermographic vision.
You do see Dragon. You see a guy, Dragon, how you describe your character?
My character?
Let's see.
Did I even put in a description?
This is for manga's purpose.
You know what? I'm gonna change my display picture so that he looks kind of... Hold on.
I'm tempted to call you Raiden.
But he's not doing naked cartwheels.
But the thing is... I actually built a sword character that's better than him. By complete accident.
You can't call him Raiden because he's not doing naked cartwheels down a hallway.
And he's the worst thing that happened to Metal Gear.
And they're going to make a game based around him.
Yeah, I know. The thing is, before I thought he was okay.
Okay, I just changed my display picture.
One of the more better scenes in that game. Was Brent okay. Cutting up things.
Also, I technically didn't need a description because I just had thermographic vision. I didn't actually see your features.
By the way, mine is the blue flames. And that's basically what he looks like. Well, I guess his ears wouldn't be that pointy with it, would they?
Probably no. They're... Alright. Probably no, but...
Okay.
But I mean, those ears. Well, what do elf ears tend to be pointier than that, right? But I think the Shadowrun book has a picture of an elf, and I think theirs are practically antennae.
And I'm back.
Hey.
Okay, the way I'm going to go in is the front door. I'm just going to walk in.
Just going to walk in and everything. Max is surprised.
Hey, I may be paranoid, but I'm not stupid.
Max is, they're surprised. Huh, you're the only... You're one of the only ones that's shown up so far. Besides, I think Team Up would
I'll
already be there,
wouldn't he? Yeah, I would have if 6 o'clock came.
Yeah. Dragon, are you currently still hiding till these two other guys show up?
Well, let's see.
Are you currently hiding in a crate, or...?
Well, I'm just gonna sort of drop down and say, hey, what's up? Sort of, yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah, at that point, the guards are like, are actually physically reaching for it. What are actually pointing their weapons in your direction? But Max says, no. He's one of the guys I asked for. He goes over to you and asks, why did you come through the window? There's a door. You honestly didn't see the door.
Oh, the door? I'm not real much of a door person.
Okay. Oh, there's one other person here.
Besides, I wanted to see
he's
how...
He's somewhere.
Besides, I want...
Everybody hates.
Wait. Besides, I
yeah,
wanted...
Yeah, they look...
I'm trying
they're
to...
looking a bit nervously at you. The guards are looking a bit suspicious of you, Teemo. But not of Dragon. A bit suspicious of Dragon just... because he just came out of the effing sky.
I was gonna
make a hand, like a gun thing with my hand, and like you know, like I'm shooting him.
Yeah.
Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm gonna add. Plus, I wanted to see how good your guards are. Yeah. I was just
they're looking at me like I'm gonna kill him. Yeah, I would do that.
Are you aware they might? Briar will fire at you.
I'm just wearing casual clothes, unarmed.
Wait, how? Max
the moment you actually start reaching for it, one of the guys actually points a gun directly, comes up to you close, and points
reach
the gun
for
directly
what?
At you.
I'm not carrying a gun. I just was making a motion with my hand like a gun.
You know the whole finger gun thing, right?
I thought you actually took it out of somewhere. Pretend to take it out of the gun. If you tried doing that, they would probably shoot you, but nah, they probably wouldn't. They look even more suspicious at you, but nah.
They have all got guns. He's got a finger gun.
So, how did...
Wait, the rest of you bring your guns? I expect Dragon Bear has swords.
I don't have a... Wait, I guess I have an AK, but I generally just... carry.
You probably would have brought your swords.
My sword, maybe the... The gun's probably slung, like, right up, like, on my back or something.
I may have brought a gun. Find it. Good luck finding my gun.
I want to pass for it.
Okay, so, now that he sees those three, does he say anything else?
All right, good. You've made it.
Yeah. Oh,
where
all right.
Where is he? I'm guessing that he's going to show, but I'm not sure if he will show.
Okay, does he say something about where's Blackie? No, don't say Blackie. Where's Rogoth?
Yeah, that's what I was. That's what he was meaning. Where is
okay.
he?
Who?
Okay, when he says that,
try and troll. You can't miss him.
When he says that, I would have already then repositioned myself into shadows, and then I just would have walked out of them and said, "I'm right here."
Son of a bitch!
And my invisibility's off, but yeah.
Huh?
I'm gonna tell Max. You need new guards.
This place is not very secure.
I'll say, well, if they have long ears, they get spotted immediately.
This is Rogoff. He's going to be helping you guys in tonight's mission.
How can we trust him?
He's run several different times with me. He's shown that the kid's shown that he's really responsible.
We'll see what happens.
All right,
and I go, and hearing him say that, I kind of laugh, coming from the idiot who made a noise coming through the window.
What are you talking about?
It in.
Oh no! Wait. Oh my bad. That was a different dude. Sorry.
I came in through the front door.
I mixed who did what. My bad.
That's fine. That's fine.
I thought Jay for some reason was. Never mind. That didn't happen.
I came in like a civil person.
I wanted to see how good the guards were.
I wanted to make sure the doors worked. I don't know.
Okay, so I didn't say anything then. Moving on.
Alright. Here's what I want you guys to do. There's been a troublesome elven gang around.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, they have a whole entire facility. Even weirder is that the building is, how should I describe it, 21st century-ish. Early 21st century-ish.
So, some old stuff here.
Yes. Very old. Including, I can't find any... There's, from what I've reported, that there's no cyberware on any of these guys, or... They have supposedly a few mages. Stuff like that. I want you to go in there and completely disrupt them.
What? Why?
They've been sort of... been terrorizing the local area. And they've started a personal war with us.
Really?
And as he says, and his comrade grins. He answers it. And if, actually, could you hear people saying stuff for them from their comlink or no?
Wait, I didn't get myself perception. Oops.
What?
Could you actually hear people talking from out locally? Like one person talking, like the person that's actually talking into the comlink? Or is that all done via Matrix?
Normal talking is normally isn't done Matrix, but if the person who's talking is a bit more worried, he may have a subvocal microphone.
No, I'm talking about someone's actually called him on his comlink. He's answering it. Could the people around him hear it?
Yes.
All right. This is how the conversation goes. Yeah? Uh-huh. Oh, they're ready. Oh. Give me that other team to do this mission. Yeah, the one about the elf gang. All right. He sort of turns back to you guys. All right, we have another plan.
Yeah, what the fuck was that about?
I've been informed that they're ready.
Who?
Car bombs.
What?
What?
You see, things haven't... You really want to know why Lone Star has been so uppity?
No, yes.
The biggest mafia Yakuza war ever. These guys have been stockpiling military equipment for almost a year. Intentions have gone is going so far that open war might be declared, and Lone Star is getting Aaron Knight's getting extremely worried that if this stuff happens, they might lose their contract.
I could do that.
These car bombs are for three specific targets. Each one disrupting a different sector. The first one is just a personal one. The first one is a humanist group. They hate all sorts of metahumans. The reason why is because a bunch of a small group of mine got attacked by them recently. And plus, I never liked humanos, anyways. The second is a mafia warehouse, and when you get there, you'll be... And there are specific instructions. You guys will basically be playing dress-up and acting as workers and dropping off crates. The crates actually have explosives in them, so when you get far enough away from the warehouse, you pull the detonator. The third one, you need to park under a You need to park under. You need to park under a building. There's a giant thing where there's actually something you can drive under for the for a good part of the building, the parking lot. I'm sorry, not the parking lot. The thing like stuff. Yeah, there's meeting going on between two Elvish gangs in the parking lot, in a abandoned in a parking complex. I need you to bring a very volatile plastic explosive car over.
A volatile plastic explosive?
That
just doesn't make sense.
Yeah. I'd be careful with the last one because you touch the radio in the car, it explodes. It's damaged too much. It will explode. So I'd be careful. Whoever's driving it, you should be very careful.
Got it.
Again, the second one, you guys are going to have to dress up and deliver crates. But I think you guys, I gave you your, I got some uniforms that look like the delivery people. That people that can deliver crates.
Okay.
So, is there anything else you would want to know about this room?
So, we're delivering a car and some crates.
Is there going to be anyone trying to stop us? Like that know we're coming?
No, none of the free targets expect this is ever coming.
What's the third target? I heard the car and the crates.
The humanists.
The humanists, I want you to hit them first while they're in their meeting.
Okay.
The car bomb you're going to plan out, you're going to actually plan out... You're actually going to plan this, there's an alcove thing where you can actually park. I want you to park in there. And then you should explode it. Then you should detonate it. All three, okay. The second one has crates you have to drop off. The third one you have to plant, the first floor of a parking complex.
How do you want us to take them out? Because the other ones you were specific on how.
Just plant the car bomb. The car bomb should be able to destroy most of the house. It should kill most of the humanists. But the thing is, they have to be at that meeting. If they aren't at that meeting, the home player plan goes to shit. So you're gonna. Their meeting is at 7. The meeting for the you're gonna be out doing this at night. So
I want to check to make sure I got this. The car bomb is going to be delivered to kill the humanists at the meeting.
Yeah, humanist chapter meeting, yes.
That's what the car bomb. So that's one thing. Okay.
There's two car bombs, I think.
Yeah, there's two car bombs. The third one, there's crates. There's bombs in the crates, but they look legitimate.
Okay, so there's a car bomb at the humanist meeting, there's a car bomb at the parking structure, and then there's crates at a house.
No, crates that are supposed to be delivered to a mafia warehouse.
Warehouse, okay. Warehouse, there we go. Crates at a warehouse... Car bomb parking structure, car bomb humanists. Okay. Are both car bombs volatile?
The one going to the parking lot is. The second one isn't.
Okay. The one going to the humanists is not volatile. Got it.
I guess I could deal with that. I am human. They might not shoot me on sight.
The thing is, if you guys do your job correctly, they won't know that. They won't know you've been there.
True. I prefer it that way.
No payments. I'm gonna start it at 25k per target, 1,000 per target. Like to hear any other offers, especially since this is immediate.
You said 20,000 per target?
25k per
25k
per target.
Each?
That's 75 total.
Yeah, each.
Oh, each?
No, split up between the whole entire party.
Oh, there we go. I was like, what?
Wait,
if you want, you could try to negotiate with me, but
Oh, funny.
Especially since I'm trying to do this, so, how should I put this?
Oh, that's a funny spell. Okay. I'm not even going to try.
What, negotiating?
Mango, what was that?
It was a failed spell. But I got the drain.
Okay, let me guess, that was your influence spell for him to give you more, wasn't it?
Yep. Well, no, it wasn't influence. It was to boost my charisma. And I was going to try talking to him.
Oh. Oh, man.
Okay. I'm fine. I could try to face somebody.
What's 75 split four ways?
But now that you mention it, I have an influence spell.
Open up the book.
No, I won't. I'm not going to abuse the influence spell.
What four ways?
Yeah, 75,000 split four ways.
Well, we're the ones doing the work. Why are you getting such a big cut?
I'm not getting a cut. Four ways is all four of you.
Hey, Kaz, sorry, I forgot that. I'm looking at the number of people on my screen rather than... I forgot to count myself.
Yeah, you should have counted yourself.
Fuck!
He's not getting anything out of this besides the, I can't say it, because it's a little too vague.
No. It's like, okay, it's just like, you know what? I don't know. I mean, we are risking our lives here. If anything goes wrong, we're totally fucked here.
Make an influence. Think, I think it's con or influence test.
Influence. Well, I don't have influence, but I have con.
Is it con or negotiation?
I have negotiation.
It's negotiation.
All right, roll your negotiation, and crap, I don't have max.
I have
I'm
a minus.
Give max.
Paranoid.
5 karma. And I'm gonna give him a point in negotiation, so that's gonna be he rolls. What do I need to avoid through resist that? Willpower?
Dude, I only got one hit, don't worry.
I'm gonna say.
Oh, I believe. I'll go check. I thought negotiation was a straight up opposed, but that might not be it.
I don't know what to oppose it with. Even though it's one, there's still the chance that Max may glitch.
Is his intuition different from his charisma?
His intuition's going to be 4.
What's his charisma?
I'm going to say 4.
Then don't bother. It doesn't matter. It's then charisma plus negotiation. Yeah.
I remember to give myself a minus 3 for this one because of the paranoia, so.
Yeah. I mean, I'll look it up, but if it shouldn't really matter. Negotiation. Yeah, it's negotiation and charisma. So that was correct. Tia, how's
negotiation
plus?
Is negotiation plus charisma?
Yeah.
Okay, negotiation plus charisma, that means he's rolling 7 to resist, I think.
Yep.
All he needs is one hit.
These stats aren't finalized by Max yet.
Oh, he made it. He got 3 hits.
Yeah, he made it. I'm gonna say, nah. I think you guys are risking enough. It's an easy and simple job. As long as you don't fuck up, it's an easy and simple job.
suppose. Yeah, I guess. I think we can pull this off.
All right, the humanist meeting is going to meet in 2 hours. I'm going to give you the location of the first car bomb in the first place. Then call me when you do that.
Okay, so whose car are we taking to get there?
We have a car bomb.
You guys need to get to the car bomb first.
Oh.
Yeah, the thing is, I can't risk hiding it here. Because only rent this place as a small storage thing, and the owner comes by every now and again, and if he saw me working on a car bomb here, that wouldn't end well. So, yeah, I don't have it here, if you're wondering.
Yeah, how's your guys' security here? Because I don't want to take my car with me.
I could hide it in the warehouse, no problem. We're pretty good.
I want someone actually keeping an eye on this thing.
I'll keep an eye on it.
Tia,
I'm gonna go
Dragon,
get my car.
Do either of your characters need a ride?
I need a ride.
I'll give Dragon a ride.
Okay. Let me go to my vehicle and get my weapons and...
Oh, no. Well, I won't... Jay insulted me, so I'm not giving him a ride. He insulted Blackie. Blackie's not giving him a ride.
I'm sure as hell I'm not taking my car. I'm afraid.
That's nice. Unless T's driving, you're standing there and we're leaving you.
Guess you should have bought a goddamn car, huh?
I do have a car.
Dragon, I thought you had a car.
What?
He sold it after I got him one.
You sold it after you got him one?
Right.
Why wouldn't you keep the car? During the time you actually had, why wouldn't you get on a bike during the week?
I did.
You could have gotten a bike during the week.
It would have gotten stolen. I'm just gonna save it up.
Oh yeah, I remember. You should have left if you want. You don't necessarily have to go off the car bomb. You could just ride along with it.
Yeah.
The thing is, someone has to pilot that car. Technically, if Jay wasn't piloting that car, Jay would actually could actually just stay with his car.
I'm okay with driving the first car bomb. I'd be willing to do that.
Actually, I have a question. Actually, the hacker should have thought to ask of this. My character
didn't.
This is out of gaming. You should have asked whether or not it still has its if it's still connected to the Matrix.
Yeah, you should have asked that. Contact him. Actually, since you're still there talking to him, actually, you can ask him now.
Fine. Is that car bomb? Is that still hooked up to the Matrix?
The first two, yes. The third one, I had to disable Matrix for.
Okay.
That car is so volatile, I'm afraid if anyone actually got into its Matrix system, it may explode. So, I had to do some very tricky things with it.
Okay, so, and Jay, what?
Do you have the command program?
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna suggest, Jay, control these.
Yeah, I was gonna RC. Oh, not the third one. That one might explode just by doing that, apparently.
Third one, we can't.
Yeah. So, okay, yeah. Well, you know, if you give me a ride there, I can control the cars, I mean, without us even getting in them, at least two of them.
You can just stay here. We don't even have to give you a ride.
4 kilometer range? Are they within that?
No. Matrix, and unless it's in a dead zone, you can still connect to the car.
Only if they got a satellite uplink.
Like I said, my character doesn't like you. He's not giving you a ride. I get in my car. Who gets in with me?
I guess I will.
I'll get in with you. Although I'll say, give me a moment to go to my SUV. I'll get my submachine gun from my smuggling compartment and my chameleon suit.
I assume Tia comes back and we drive off, leaving Jay there.
Okay, fine. Then I'm going to stay here and go into VR and get into the car.
What do you have for your signal? Did you get 6 yet?
It's 5, so 4 kilometers if it's within that.
How large is Seattle? I think it's Seattle is more than 4 kilometers.
Well, yeah, I mean the car itself. Okay, otherwise, fine. I have to get in my car and drive along with them.
Alright.
No, he doesn't! How do you guys...
He said my signal. That generally means it's not in a satellite uplink, so I couldn't connect.
I didn't know if Seattle was 4 kilometers wide.
Okay. Unless you guys are running the Matrix completely different, he doesn't have to be in that signal range as long as it's not in a dead zone.
Think of the Matrix like Wi-Fi. You could connect to it almost anywhere.
Then what's the point
of the range? You can use another connection all the way across at another point of Seattle to connect to the car. You don't have to be in that signal range unless you're in a dead zone or if there's jamming.
Okay. Okay, so I can get to it from here.
Yes.
Fine.
I wouldn't recommend leaving your car yourself alone.
You know what I'll do? I'll get in my car and make it invisible, and then I'll do it.
Alright. That's possibly the optimal choice.
Yeah.
The better choice would be to turn the cars to have cameras on the car, have motion sensors on, and have it alert you in the Matrix, but I don't think he has all those on his car.
Nah, he still needs to work for those.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll do that. And what do I need to roll to get into the car now? Oh, wait, I gotta say what I have turned on first.
Stealth, he did give you the passcodes to the first two cars. The third one, I think you want to tell them what happened. I think you want to tell them, but since Rogoff decided not to give you a ride, you can refuse not to tell them.
I ain't telling them shit.
All right.
I don't even have his contact info. Okay, so I guess I'll turn on stealth command. And just trying to think what I'm going to need.
It's usually always good to carry a black hammer and an attack. Oh, my biofeedback filter if you're doing cold or hot sim.
I'm not going to go in hot. There's no reason to do that right now.
Yeah, so you're going in cold sim, throw on a biofeedback filter, throw on black hammer and attack. There you go. You have 5 programs then.
Stealth command, biofeedback, black hammer attack. That sounds good. Or maybe you should swap out one for armor.
Armor only works if you're an AR. Well, no, kind of. Yes and no.
Okay, then yes. Stealth, just in case. Black hammer, command, attack, and biofeedback. That's what I'm going in with.
Yeah. Right. Armor only works if someone's using an attack program on you. And since you're in VR, a lot of people probably won't bother with attack. If you're fighting something, they'll probably go straight to blackout or black hammer. So that's why I'm saying armor is kind of like, if you're just in VR, it's one of those things where it might come in handy, but a lot of times, eh.
Right, so anyways, I'm in VR and connecting to the car. Do I need to do any rolls because I got the passcode?
Nope. No.
Okay, and I went in cold.
Right. Alright, now you see what the car sees. Does he see what the car sees or no?
Yeah, pretty much.
Cars have that front camera, I believe. And
okay, so now there's actually, he gave you the location, so you're going to drive to that location now?
I'm going to wait for the rest. You know what?
Yeah.
I'm going to wait until... What time is it right now in-game?
6:30.
Okay. I'm going to go... Okay, that location, I'm not going to go to it, but nearby, like maybe a street or a block away, and wait.
All right. Because
I'm going to get there at the meeting.
Did you actually see the house or no?
I'll drive by it at least once to see the house just to get a location.
It looks like an abandoned. It looks sort of like an abandoned building.
Do I need to roll?
Decent sized.
Drive it properly or no?
I would have liked to say to get in here. I don't. I would have went straight to the building to with the group, so we could check it out.
You're just supposed to plant the car bomb here.
I know, but we have to make sure they're at the meeting.
All right. When did you guys get there?
I would have drove straight there, kind of, so we could set up. Not there. There, like, give us like a 5-block radius or something.
The little ones.
All right. You actually do see an abandoned building. Since you guys were never told what the car bomb looks like, you do see another car parked, but you don't know what it is.
Jay would have beat us there? Never mind.
How close that other car was. Yeah. If that other car was already closer to them than you were, then technically, yeah, if you think in distance-wise.
Yeah, that's what I was asking.
Yeah, I was closer.
Okay.
So you guys see a parked car with no one in it.
I go say to Dragon Tia, one of you go call the idiot hacker, make sure he's got the car in the place. The other one, I suggest maybe finding... I look at Tia, this is like... Looks like you got a nice stealth suit there. Or actually, they both have stealth suits. That's right. It's like, and then one of you go check out, go invisible, go and check out to make sure the meeting's going.
You want me to go?
That's all I'd say. It's up to you two to decide. It's up to you two to decide. I'm just.
You do see quite a few cars parked nearby. So you may think the meeting is going on, but yeah, I'm trying to peek in to see if it's going on. It's a good idea.
Oh, I just assumed we'd climb up on a roof and just use binoculars or something.
Yeah, that'd probably be the best idea.
That's what I meant. I didn't fully say it out because I wasn't, like, going in the building. I was just checking out. So
what's the building, like, across from it?
Building across from it looks like an abandoned convenience store.
Candy!
There might still be candy in there.
Let's see.
The neighborhood's recently fallen into disarray. And every once in a while, you hear distant gunfire.
The dragon, there could be Twinkies in there. They last a long time.
But soon, the Twinkie population in Shadowrun will run out.
Oh, no!
I'm thinking I just use my vision.
Tia and Jay, you two should have your character conversation since you're calling him.
Tia, why don't you go ahead and call him?
What do you want me to do?
You're calling Jay to make sure he has the car in place, because we don't know for sure.
All right. Jay, is the bomb ready?
I saw you guys walk past. I mean, the drive past. I'm pretty close. Just let me know when they're there so I can drive it in.
Okay. And I guess we're just waiting.
Okay, I'll...
Did you get there before or after he said the time when the meeting was going on?
Do you want me to use...
Well, I assume we would have got there before.
Do you want me to use my goggles to check if everyone's in the meeting?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you'd parked it before, I would think.
If you got in there before, they're probably not there yet.
I'm going to go into the abandoned convenience store, go up to the...
You're probably going to see them actually go into the building.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's what I was saying. That's why we drove there, so we would know with the meeting to make sure it was going on.
And oh, look, here's someone observing.
Yep.
Why don't we just... Well, we know that the meeting's going on right now. Why don't we just blow it up as soon as possible?
Ed, isn't... You guys said you got there before.
Yeah.
So you so guys are going to have to wait.
I thought you meant, like, before as in before it starts, not, like, 30 minutes before.
Well, he said
I meant about five to ten minutes.
Down and all that. Yeah.
I meant 5 to 10 minutes.
You actually see people. You see a lot of people going in. I'm sorry.
Yeah, because I would assume it would only take about 10 minutes for 10 minutes max for Dragon to get up onto a roof or something with the chameleon suit and scope and to be able to tell us when. We should to be able to relay it to Tia to relay it to Jay when to blow it.
You know, I do have a comp.
Yeah,
I do have.
Basically, you see it actually going in.
What, me?
Yeah, you see all of them go in.
Yeah, I'm in the abandoned convenience store looking through my goggles.
Yeah, you see them go in.
Okay. What time is it?
Twinkie?
What time is it in game? Because we're...
It's now 8 o'clock.
Isn't that past the meeting time?
Meeting starts.
The meeting is probably going on, just started.
Okay.
Which means now might be the time.
Okay, I'm just going to relay to Tia that I see a lot of people going in. Or I just saw a lot of people go in, so it now might be the meeting is probably gonna just started, so now might be the time to blow up the car. And I'm telling this to Tia, right?
All right, I'll send everybody to get the show on the road.
Okay, I'm gonna try. Okay, I'm gonna drive by up casually. And okay, this is just a house, you said, or is it what is it?
Yeah, it's a building, but it has this thing where you can park right next to it. There's no car there.
Okay, I'm saying, but it doesn't look like a normal, like just a house.
No, it doesn't look like a normal house. It looks like a small abandoned building.
Okay, then park up real close. Set the timer to, let's say, 10 seconds, and then log off so I don't dump shock.
Alright. And this is what Dragon and your free character see. You see that car explode. You see that the building also explodes. That the building with it goes down with it. Like it starts to really go down.
Get Dragon
starts to collapse.
However, it does damage a few of the... It actually does... thankfully, it wasn't... It actually was a bit unstable, so yeah. That happens because of the explosives. You guys see a fireball and explosions. You do see a people come out... You do see, like, a dead person come out. Apparently, he caught on fire.
I'm gonna just back away... slowly, and then go out through the back door of the convenience
store. All right, going back to the back door. All right.
I would assume I'd go pick him up.
Of course.
Yeah, like 5 blocks away.
I start wondering if this is all really necessary.
Okay, call up Tia. So what's next?
See, that was the humanist. Mm-hmm. Was the elf gang priority two, or was it the
mafia warehouse? Mafia warehouse. Yeah.
Okay, so what do you need to do now?
I guess you need to maneuver the next car bomb to the mafia warehouse.
I thought that was not a car bomb.
You guys,
that was not a car bomb.
You guys already fought differently. Max wanted you to contact him when it was finished, so.
Alright, well then I'll contact Max and say the humanists are gone.
Alright. You're gonna have to get. when they get to the van, tell them to put on the suits. It's good if they have it, they should have a driver. I'm saying that now. The Mafia men may get very suspicious if there's no driver. So you may actually want to have a physical driver for this one.
Okay. Then I call them back up. Or whatever.
And the disguise, he also tells you that the disguises are in the truck.
Well, relay all this.
Okay, well, let's see. My disguise is... Am I supposed to, like, deliver anything through the truck, or...
Yeah, if you don't... You actually should be. They're expecting things to be dropped off, but they're only expecting free crates to be dropped off.
Alright.
Oh, wait, this is the crates?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I'd probably go drive to pick up the crates.
You should use the vehicle, too.
There's a vehicle?
Yeah, there's a vehicle in them. There's a vehicle. In the vehicle, there's not only the crates, but there's a suit you could use to fool them, as in you're actually dropping things off.
Okay.
Okay, so at another location, we have a vehicle... with suits and crates inside it. Okay.
You guys will look like a delivery service if this goes smoothly.
All right, I'll put on one of the suits, and I say, I guess I'll be the driver.
Just in case, I'll log into that one too, so if that car, just in case, you know?
All right.
TDL will drive, I'm just saying that... I'll be logged into it.
I'll follow behind a distance. I look at Dragon. Do you want to get in? Do you want to go with him?
What, me? I'm going to put on the disguise and go with you.
There you go. Go with Tia.
Yeah. Good. Okay.
Tim, I really need to know your characters' names again.
Dragon's character is Rook. Jay probably wouldn't tell you his, so I'm not going to say it.
He's Hacker Bitch. That's all I need. Yeah.
Hacker Bitch.
Watch what happens to you. I'm already planning.
I already know his
Please
name.
Don't kill my players, Jay.
Oh, I didn't say kill. I'm not going to kill anybody. I'm not going to kill anybody.
And Tia?
Good, I would have to get the war bell if you did.
Tia?
Yeah.
What's up?
You're not playing your character name? Again, are you?
Dalem.
What?
Dalem.
Dalem?
Okay. Dalem, the prancing elf. Is your character gay, Manga? I just need to know this.
No.
Okay, he's not the flamboyant elf again. Alright. Basic, you should have been here last session. I already told him about this.
For this mission, I'll use my machine pistol holdout instead of my...
Instead of your big, bulky SMG. Dragon may want to leave the swords at home. We want to leave the swords in Manga's thing. But if you have a holdout, you might be able to use it. Hold out some machine gun, hold out pistol...
Well, I can't just say it's for decoration.
Uzi, it's not doing some shit for a fork, for that matter. Well, maybe not. Maybe not a fork.
Okay. I guess we drive the vehicles over.
Alright. You drive the vehicle over. You actually see a guy just standing there. He looks at the driver. He notices the uniform in the truck and he buzzes you guys. The gate opens. And also the warehouse opens.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'll drive up. And I'll park her next to most amount of damage it can do.
No, you have to drop off. You have to drop off the crate. You get to keep the vehicle.
It's not a car bomb.
Oh. close. Is it a van or a truck?
It's a van. Why wouldn't it be a van? It's delivering things.
So I imagine there'd be a receiving area then, where there'd just be like, it's a designated drop-off point, so then I'll just park there and open up the back.
Is it like one of those big shipping vans, or is this more like a free candy van?
This is more,
I like a big white van.
Big white van, you know, the ones with the trailers on them and the short square ones?
Yeah, yeah, so not a free candy inside van.
Not a free candy inside van, Jay.
Oh. Okay.
Alright, well, when I park, I said, well, let's get these crates out of here and get out of here as fast as we can.
Alright.
Do you want us to roll agility and strength, or just assume it goes smoothly, or what?
I'm going to assume it goes smoothly, unless any of you have strength under 2.
Nope.
Nope.
Good thing I'm not there.
So you do it. You do notice, however, it seems like the Mafia guys are armed with assault and battle rifles. They seem to be a little more
on edge.
Yeah. Even more so that you catch a glimpse of a devil rat actually being moved through the bay.
What's a devil rat?
It's a cute little furry creature that is fun to have as a pet.
No, I mean the APC. I considered it widely available, so I just gave it to them because I like Devil Rat, because I like that vehicle.
Oh, the vehicle. Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about the critter.
No, I could find rabbit critters easily. Remember that.
No, devil rat is actually a paranormal critter in Shadowrun.
A devil rabbit is a critter I just made up out of my own head.
Good for you.
In fact, I'm going to stat it. Yeah, highly infectious. One scratch, you're infected with
AIDS.
You'd wish it was AIDS.
No, I wouldn't.
Man, because they cure AIDS in Shadowrun. Alright, let's continue. Besides that, you don't notice anything else. I think they actually gave you instructions. The Mafia guys actually gave you instructions of where to put the crates. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. You put the crates where they're supposed to go, and I'm assuming you're getting the hell out of there.
Yeah. What else are we gonna do?
Alright. You guys drive away, you're out, you're turning, you're going, and behind you, boom, the whole entire warehouse, warehouse place, actually explosions start coming from it. Multiple explosions.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot to get into view.
Yeah, Manga gets to miss the fireworks.
No, I meant to do it with this time. I meant to get myself in a nice viewpoint and watch it go up. But I forgot. Oh well. I hear the explosions and I cry for missing the explosions.
I call Max. No more Mafia.
Alright, the Mafia district's down. That Mafia warehouse is down. Good, that's going to cripple them significantly. Alright, you guys know the third one. Yeah, now, all you just need to do is plant that car bomb.
I can't even do that. If I go in, it explodes.
One of you needs to manually drive it.
I'll drive it.
Just be real careful.
Out of it if it goes bad.
Just be real careful. This is 20 tons of plastic This is 20 tons of plastic explosive.
What, 20 tons? Then how's
what kind of a vehicle is this? Jeez.
I sort of went a little overboard.
A little?
If it's a car, it can't even move anymore.
Okay, that's unreal. That's fucking a track vehicle.
Quaz, do you mean kilos? Instead of tons? tons? Did you mean to say kilos?
Yeah.
Yeah, because my truck that I've got parked outside is a half ton.
Yes. Quascake mixed up kilos and tons.
Yeah, it's, only yeah, 20 kilos. It's metric. It gets fucky sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have to be careful. When I'm not going to have you roll the evil driving test that was supposed to be here in my notes. Because it says for every 5 minutes, you would have to roll driving test so you won't explode it. But I'm not going to do that since it's 20 kilos of plastic explosive.
Well, I would see roll a luck dice 5 times. If every time one comes up, he has to make a driving test to avoid another car hitting him.
You want to know what? We'll do that.
You know what I just realized?
If you're lucky, you just go right through. If you're lucky.
Guys, you know what I just realized?
What?
With me logged into that van and the fact that I can control it, I can also say, beep, beep, I'm a Jeep.
That would have actually scared the crap out of the mafia guys.
Okay. So, first roll, he's fine.
No, I'm here for 15 minutes. But
you want me to do it?
Yeah, I wanted you to do it, but...
Oh, okay.
We'll keep the 5.
He is driving it, but...
We'll keep the 5.
Oh, this is just the luck roll. That's all.
Oh, luck.
1, 2, 3, 4...
As long as he doesn't hit a 1, he doesn't have to make a reaction test.
Alright, he didn't roll 1 for any of the 5. You get there. And I'm hoping that the other 2 are nearby, too.
I'm still logged in the van, so whatever they... Doesn't matter what they want, I'm driving the van not too close behind, but to follow them. So when he's done with the car, I can give him a ride.
I've been driving.
Yeah, the delivery van.
Yeah, delivery van. Not Menga's van, that's his van. Or whatever.
Yeah.
No, because I never logged out of the delivery van.
Mm-hmm. So.
Okay, Tia, you go in there, you go to the specific place. I want you to roll perception hearing. Just you. Only you.
All right. Perception. All right, I have 4, but then I got 3 for audio and 3 for visual.
Use the audio. Nah, you don't hear anything strange.
2 hits, alright.
In fact, you nearly glitched.
Well, nearly glitch doesn't count as anything.
If you add unlucky, it might.
No.
Unlucky
doesn't do that.
GM rule. That would be a fun GM rule.
What you're thinking of is gremlins.
Oh, gremlins.
Oh, God, no.
That's what they do. I almost forgot about gremlins.
I give double karma for people who use gremlins because I love gremlins. But no one ever uses it.
Yeah, no one ever uses lucky either. I've never seen anyone use that.
Unlucky? All right, well,
lucky.
Oh, yeah. I'll use it occasionally if I'm making a human.
I'll park outside the designated area.
Okay.
Before I pull in or whatever.
You're walking out, you're going back to the van. The explosives trigger. Now, here's everything that happens. Because this is a long sequence of events. Are you still watching the building, Manga?
Oh yeah, this one I would have got a nice position in.
You notice...
Did you say something?
He's thinking.
Oh, okay.
You're at the vehicle now, right, Tima? The Manga's vehicle?
No, it would have been towards Jay's van.
Yeah.
I went
for a position to see everything, so the delivery van's probably closer.
All right.
And I'd have been walking casually, too. I wouldn't have been running or sprinting.
Because you see the building explode.
Remember, T-Man, cool guys don't look at explosions. They just walk away.
Yeah, it's
but as you got... But the explosions go off, you start hearing cars coming from the other two directions.
Alright, I'll send a comlink. We got company, and I'll start running towards Chase Van.
And and you actually see this very, very pissed, mind you. You see this very, very pissed Japanese-looking man holding a katana. It looks like it has blood on it.
Do I have my
sword? How close is he to me?
And two other guys with silenced machine guns. You were almost turning around the corner. He actually notices you as the guy who stole the precious thing.
Which thing?
The precious thing.
The drow?
Yes, the precious thing. It's supposed to be derivative, but you can assume it's the drow.
Super duper.
So they're now trying to kill you.
I just came back. That my dogs were outside and a rainstorm just started, like rain slash windstorm. My dogs were outside.
I imagine I'm still wearing that delivery uniform over my chameleon suit, so I'd start trying to take that off as I run if you want me to roll something for that.
Yeah, agility, I think it is.
For a running test or for what? What's the test?
Taking off my delivery uniform while I'm running.
Yeah, okay, that's an agility.
How many hits? 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to say he does it.
Alright, then I would activate my chameleon suit.
Alright.
And of course, I'm still running.
You now, Manga notices that the guys actually getting out are also Yakuza, and they're looking, searching around the place. If you're close enough, they probably are going to see you.
They're at the site?
Yeah.
I would be far away, but at a position where I can still see what's going on. That was the whole thing. I just wanted a good position to watch, but it wasn't close. So
am I supposed to run with did Tia run or
Yeah, Tia ran.
Oh, do I see Tia running?
Yeah. Away from the guys. The guys actually look pretty pissed. You guys see him too. There's this guy with an angry Japanese man with a sword, and these two guys with silent assault rifles. I looked at my notes and checked them. They're assault rifles.
How close am I to Jay's van?
Well, like I said, I was kind of tailing you before when you were driving up there.
I'm trying to figure out where my character would be.
Probably like 100 yards.
Where
I assume you would still in the delivery van. Points.
Okay, sure.
You didn't say you got out of it, so I assumed you were still in it.
Yeah. I have my sword.
Alright.
Yeah, you probably left it in Manga's thing, so you're probably... Wait, did you get in Manga's thing?
What? Yeah.
Yeah, then you have your sword.
No, he's in the delivery van still, and his sword is still in my vehicle.
Your sword's still in his vehicle.
No, see, after... Yeah, but since I see... Look, after the second explosion, I obviously got my swords back.
Alright, you have your swords.
Okay.
This might be the perfect opportunity to try melee versus melee combat, finally.
Okay.
Finally, Dragon, they get to shine.
Tia run. At this point, I'm gonna throw a stun ball.
Throw your stun ball. You're leaning out of the car and throwing a stun ball.
How does range modifier work for physical spells?
I don't know.
I have to go check that again.
Yeah,
it's a mana spell, though. It's not a physical that I'm throwing. It's
no
a mana
stun?
Spell.
I'm a little...
Oh, okay.
I swear stun was physical.
I'm a little worried about...
Stunbolt's physical.
Because I do use Stunbolt.
Yeah, Stunbolt's a mana spell.
What happens if I get into melee with that katana guy while his followers are firing at me? Would they hold their fire? Would they run?
If you and him actually want to go at it, he actually may just decide to fight you one-on-one if both of you are holding your swords out. There's a pretty good chance. Considering this guy looks Japanese and he seems to be Yakuza-ish, there's a good chance happening.
Okay, so he might decide to go on with a one-on-one duel.
Could be an episode of Kill Bill.
Yes.
He would tell the others to back off, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh. Ooh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Does he seem honorable enough to back off if he loses?
I'm doing 5 stun damage to either 2 of those guys or 3 of them. I have a 5-meter radius on my stun ball.
I'd recommend going after the guys with guns.
Huh?
I recommend going after the guys with guns.
Well, I don't know where they are, position-wise.
Well, front of the building.
I'm going to get out.
No, away from the 3 guys. I don't know how far they are from each other.
A meter?
Oh, I can hit all 3 of them.
What? Yeah?
Okay. Well, at least I got my stun roll. Okay. I hit all 3 of them for 5 stun damage.
Okay. Is that resisting with body or not resisting with body?
They can resist with willpower.
Oh, willpower instead. What did I put for these guys' willpower?
2.
Maybe I should use a flashbang.
When I was 4... When I was 4.
Should I use tear gas or... multi?
That would be dishonorable, and they'll probably fire at you.
Alright, I'm gonna get out of the van and point my sword at the katana guy. The other guy.
I know this dragon.
The stealth combat has to go through, so
I'll pull out my holdout machine pistol.
So this is for the first guy. Manga. Whoever's rolling it, click.
Oh,
one of the guys glitched. That's not going to be the guy for dragon fights.
Hey.
What happens when that guy glitches? Does he take more damage?
Normally, yeah.
How much more damage?
That's a critical glitch, so that's going to hurt him a lot.
Okay, one guy got 2 hits, so he's taking 3 stun.
Can I do the glitch?
You can have a banana.
I was going to say he's running, he gets hit by a stun ball, he trips, hits his head on a... the dumpster, it splits open, he dies.
No, he actually gets shocked so bad that something hits him in the head and knocks him out.
It'd probably just be more some damage.
Yeah, so me in the van here is wondering why the fuck you aren't in the van yet.
No, he gets an erection.
What?
What? Basic, no.
If it's electrical, yeah. All the muscles tense up.
Then shoot him.
The thing is, when you get electrocuted, all your muscles tense up, so you kind of would get an erection.
They do say the adrenaline in combat does actually get people aroused.
I'm not going to do what Basic just suggested, but he gets knocked out. He now has a boner. Congratulations, Basic. You're someone click my 46. Manga click. So I manga click. So and that guy's for doing 1. So The first guy is knocked out. The second guy has...
takes four stun.
Four stun. And the third guy takes free stun.
Four stun. No.
I mentioned the dragon's character. I did hear some sirens. We should really not dilly-dally around.
You guys haven't heard any sirens yet.
Oh, you said I heard alarms and stuff.
No, you heard cars, and those cars parked, and
car alarms. Got out of them.
No, not car alarms. Actual, more Yakuza arrived.
And all the Yakuza are out fighting now, right?
You pointed your sword at him. He seems to accept the challenge, and his guys seem to... Well, the one that isn't knocked out seems to back off.
Okay.
Gaz, can I be an asshole?
What do you want to be an asshole about?
Let's roll a van to run people down.
Do it!
Yes.
Wait, what? Oh.
I was going to run them over. Not the guy with the katana, the guys with the guns.
Oh, my bad, Quizcake.
You want to slam into the actual car?
I thought you said they were. I thought they were out shooting.
Yeah, you could probably still crash into them, slam into the car.
You know what? No. Better idea. Well, maybe I'll take one of their cars.
Okay, you want to hack into one of their cars?
Can I do that?
Yeah, firewall's free, system free. Go ahead.
Okay, roll hacking, right?
Yep.
This time, fast hacking, so... Where the fuck is my skill?
Fast hacking means that they get a... What do they get?
This is a fast hack situation, so...
They gotta try to detect every single attempt he has to do anything?
Every time he makes a hacking roll, they get to make a detecting roll.
And that's a firewall plus system.
Good thing I'm going in with stealth. Like, it's what I had.
Oh, yeah, it is. Okay.
Yeah, the firewall and system rating is 6.
What is he trying to hack?
One of their cars?
It's firewall.
Yeah, Quizcake. I'm going to say it's probably a 4, maybe a 5 for a car.
Okay.
Look at the standard cars and just look at what they have.
I mean, I could say anti-theft, but I'm not sure that doesn't do anything.
It's higher, yeah, but not for...
No, I just meant look at a standard car and check out what they have for what their system and stuff is. It's cars don't have that good of a natural thing. That's what I was saying.
I was told firewall plus system.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. I was like...
No, it's probably basic, military helicopters.
Right, it's firewall plus analyze. Yeah. Like, were they good cars or were they basic? I thought they were good cars. That's what I was saying, 4 or 5.
They're basic. They have firewall free, system free.
Oh, okay. And it is firewall plus analyze. Oh, pilot, yeah.
Okay, so I just roll hacking or...
You roll your hacking skill, not the dice pool, the skill itself, plus the exploit program.
Okay, so 6.
Which should be 11. Or, no, maybe not. I don't know what your skill is.
What program did you say?
What's your skill level? What's your skill level on hacking?
The hacking by itself is 6.
You're on.
Oh, that's logic. Then you have 11. Hang on, that's logic 6. Total 13, so...
Yeah.
So yeah,
ignore
skill
the total. It's skill ignore
6.
The dice pool. The skill is 6. Okay.
Skill 6,
then,
yes.
Then you're rolling 11 dice.
Okay. Which program was I using to do that? You mean exploit?
Exploit.
No.
Exploit.
All right, that's
this
11.
This one basic gets vocal. I heard you and him have an argument about what Optimize is supposed to do.
For
It wasn't an argument, it was the whole we discovered the bullshit of the Shadowruns books.
That's unwired, so it doesn't apply.
4 hit.
Yeah, that's unwired, that doesn't apply. Till I make an anti-mute, it doesn't apply.
Oh, I forgot to say, I want to go for admin.
Alright. How many hits do you get?
4.
You're in.
Okay. In that case...
Oh, I'll make a program, basic. Just watch. I will make a program. I swear I will before I introduce him wired.
Why are you so worried about mute?
They get one action to do anything they wanted?
Yes basic, and no. Basic, that's not true.
Basic disabled an alarm with that.
Yeah.
Since he tied. That but the system tied with finding him. Since the system is offender, I'm going to... But he had mute. He got to do something.
Yeah. Mute just gives you one extra action before the alarm goes off. That doesn't mean you always get it. That just means, say, you were trying to exploit, you got detected, you would have one more roll, and then the system would go off. If you didn't make it in. It's not that great. It gives you one extra turn to do something before you get screwed.
Okay.
He disabled an alarm in one turn.
That's probably because he had a shit ton of stuff to make him really good at hacking.
He just said, I disabled an alarm.
Okay. Moving on.
Okay, so I'm in?
That's why I'm making anti-mute.
Oh, okay, so if I'm in, I'm going to run a bitch over.
Alright. You should have used your car and, actually, you could use this car to slam into the other car.
Except Dragon Train is close and it would kill him.
Nah, you can avoid him. There's two cars on the sides, and there's three guys. You could probably maneuver around them and smash into the other car that just arrived.
Alright, but aren't there, like, guys walking around?
No, they're pointing guns from their cars, from the perimeter of their cars. The second one just arrived, and they look like they're almost getting out, but...
Okay, then. Yeah, the one where they're almost getting out, I'm gonna hit that bitch.
Okay, speed forward, and you just hit them like a train.
Oh, do cars have some kind of like a speaker or system in them, or like a PA or something? Do they? Like, do cars
have a speaker? I'm gonna say this one does.
Okay, then, right when I'm about to hit the guy, beep, beep, I'm a Jeep!
You hit them, and they're like, what the beep?
There's a spook, I'm like, what the fuck? Beep, beep! And yeah, ram them.
Yeah, you ram them?
Yeah.
You ram them, and... They just go, as far as you want to go with that car, you can. If you get enough speed, that is.
What I want to do... cruise control, basically lock the speed at the max, and then log out.
So they just crash into it. It just crashes into them, keeps going forward.
Pretty much.
I'm rolling two. I'm gonna roll something for them to their edge.
Beep, beep, boom!
I want to see if one of the guys gets lucky and jumps out of the car. I want to see if one of the guys get lucky. So, manga click. Initialize the click.
Oh.
Oh my god!
He did.
I want to see what happens with the other two.
Hey, was that a critical hit?
Well, one of the guys is absolutely fucked.
Critical hit is all sixes. Or all hits. I think it's all sixes, but...
Well, that
That's a critical!
One of the guys, badass, just kicks out the door and jumps on... And makes a full jump outside the car. And now he actually has... With his weapon pointed. He's like, what the hell just happened? The other guy manages to roll. One of the guys manages to roll out, but he's still now pretty injured. And then the third guy, it rams into a building. Both cars explode and kills him.
Main reason I did that, they're down two cars, harder for them to chase you guys.
They're down two cars. However, there's now one really pissed off guy with an assault rifle. That assault rifle has a grenade launcher.
Fine, let him shoot at the guy who just tried to kill him, the car. It's possessed. Oh.
They're still searching to find out what happened.
Hey guys, this is your distraction.
Actually, they've already... I have to play out the sword fight with,
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright.
All right, so, do we roll initiative, or...?
Yeah, you two roll initiative. I want to know how many passes you have.
Those two are still inside of me?
What? Did you just
I
say?
Have, I have adrenaline surge, but roll my initiative.
Property.
Oh my. Quaz, are both. Is Tia's character still in my line of sight?
Yeah, Tia's character is still in your line. Actually, okay. You can still see the van, yeah.
Okay, so.
Not.
I have an initiative of 11. And that's it.
Alright.
Do I still go first?
You don't have any passes?
You got no hits.
What?
You don't have any other passes?
What do you mean?
Initiative passes.
I have two passes. Two initiative passes. Why?
Oh, two initiative passes. I was just curious.
Wait, were you... You were talking to me, right?
Yeah, I was talking to you. So that's going to be 5, 9, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Okay.
I do have adrenaline surge though, so I would automatically go first unless they edge.
Oh, you want to go first? You want to actually participate in the melee combat? Go ahead.
No, I'm gonna save my turn for an interrupt.
Oh, you're gonna save your turn for an interrupt. Okay. All
right. So.
Okay, so it's going to be his turn. Since you're both using technically both using swords, you could actually parry it using your sword skill.
Yeah.
So he's going to attack. And I need to roll to hit with a melee weapon, so. No, I'm just going to get a little personalized grip. That's too. Hold on, my camera froze. Alright, so he's rolling. We'll either dodge or parry those.
I'll just parry it.
Yeah. If I remember you correctly, you have 17.
16 d6 for parrying.
No, I meant use your... If you have a blade skill, go ahead, use it.
What?
If you have a blade skill specialty, go ahead, use it.
Yeah, but...
The
thing is...
You...
I'm supposed to use reaction, not agility. So...
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for his result. First, before I roll.
Wow, a hit.
One hit. Alright, here's my parry. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, you parry it.
How do I use disarm if it...
Since now your turn... You could.
You have to say it at the beginning.
Oh, okay.
You could. I gave you a sword that could do stun damage as well as lethal damage.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm gonna quick draw my other sword. Can I do that?
I'm not sure if he can do use both swords. Can he?
Yeah, I can do two sword fight.
He can technically use both swords, but I'm pointing out here.
Would he have to split the dice pool? Is that the problem?
No. He's doing a dodge, right?
I was doing a parry.
You're doing a parry. Okay, with a parry, you wouldn't be. It's not actually your turn yet, so I don't. You can't use your free action to do the quick draw. Mm-hmm.
No, I'm gonna quick draw.
It's a melee. It was a melee, so my character's turn's over.
Yeah, so I'm quick drawing on my turn.
Didn't you say you were parrying to as a reaction, right? That uses your turn. Do a parry.
Okay.
I believe. I'll check.
But,
Oh.
Well, quick draw is a free action, so I don't know if that...
Yeah. Oh, no, the thing was... okay, my bad. I thought you were going to quick draw to block with both of them.
That's no, what I no. You were I'm just going to block with one of them and then quick draw on my turn.
Okay. That's a different thing. But I don't think you have a turn. Let me check.
Because I parried?
Yeah, I have to check to see if it's full defense.
I don't think it is, but...
Well, you got your two passes still before the next combat phase.
Oh, okay. I guess
it's not a full.
No. Oh, yeah. You can do a simp. There's a full parry and there's a simple parry, so you're fine.
What's full parry?
You get to use your unarmed combat skill times 2 plus reaction. Or your whatever weapon skill times 2.
Okay.
That's the full parry. But if you're just doing a reactionary parry, then yeah.
Okay, I'm going to quick draw my other sword first so that I can use the maneuver that lets me full parry with one sword and swing with the other. Okay, so that's a reaction plus weapon skill test, right?
Yeah.
I think that... Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. And then I'm going to swing with the other sword.
Oh, wait. Your quick draw? Your quick draw, I think, is an agility. Sorry, I thought that was your roll to parry.
Wait, what? No. Mm-hmm. I already parried. This is my second roll.
Oh, I didn't notice this, that.
This,
okay.
This is my... The second roll is my quick draw roll. And... This is my swing, my attack roll.
Oh, okay. It is a reaction test. Okay.
Could someone click that? Manga, could you do that thing so I can see his roll?
Sorry.
Okay, so that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Dragon, is that quick draw an arsenal martial art specialty?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's why I couldn't find it. Is it actually called quick draw?
Yeah.
Okay, so if I wanted, I could either dodge him using I want to do a partial dodge, so I still get his next initiative pass. So that would be just his dodge skill.
Digit.
Or what would I roll to? What else would I roll besides the sword skill? I'm just curious.
You talking to me?
Yeah.
What are you talking to me about?
Dodging mouse.
He has a sword out. He'd be rolling his reaction plus his sword skill, unless he's doing full. Does he still have an initiative pass left?
Yeah, he still has an initiative pass.
Then he could do a full one if he wanted to, using up his next action, but up to you.
So he'll be using reaction instead of agility?
Yeah. Reaction plus weapon skill. If you want him to do a full, it's weapon skill times 2 plus reaction.
One, two, three, four, five, six. No, he didn't make it. He didn't do his parry correctly.
Okay.
He only got six hits, so okay. I think you add one to your damage, four, I think it is.
No, three. Six, seven, he has three eight, over you. He adds three to his damage.
Alright.
Wait. I got 9 hits. I think. 1, 2.
Yeah, you have 9 hits. He got 6 hits on his defense. That's a difference of 3. You add that 3 to your damage.
Okay.
And is it a sword or katana? I can't tell if their damage is the same.
Katana.
It depends on his strength.
Let's see. My katana says it's damage 8P or 8S. Stun damage, right? So that's 11 stun damage in total.
You have a blade on it, right? That's physical.
Hmm? No. Cascade.
I let him have something special.
It's a sack.
Since he was a pacifist, I let him have a special sword.
It's a sacabato, really.
Oh, okay. So it's a dulled blade?
Yeah.
Basically?
Yeah, it's dulled.
Oh, okay.
I originally gave him something that will allow him to do both, but he didn't want it.
Meaning that the dull side is sharp, but the sharp side is dull. So it's like tension sword.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, that I just wanted to check, not that it was a special sword that also does shock damage.
8 plus 3 is...
11.
Alright, 11, so... To resist,
you roll his body plus his impact armor.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven.
4 stun.
4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright.
Got 11 stun damage on you, so... Yeah.
Oh man, now he has an even bigger penalty for when he does his next action.
Good.
Okay.
Manga, what was that roll?
For? It's my turn in the combat.
Oh, yeah. What are you doing that for him?
I was casting improved reflexes.
This was supposed to be a 1-1 fight. You do know that, right?
I can still throw spells from the distance.
If you involve in any way, you are getting notoriety. You do know this, right? Assuming something survives.
Assuming something can see me, I'm using mana spells. They aren't flash and booms. That's the benefit of mana spells. They do not make it obvious where you're casting from. It's not like I'm shooting a jet of fire for myself.
So mana spells are more like just...
So 1, 2, 3, 4. How many... What force did you need?
Oh, I didn't... I was going for a force 4, but unfortunately I only got enough to do, I can only do 3 hits, so I actually end up only having a plus 2 to my initiative, 18. And my initiative passes.
Alright.
Oh, wait, no, I had 3 hits. 3 hits. Yeah, 3 hits is a plus 2 to each. Yeah. Alright. So I'm up to... What is it? I'm up to an initiative of 12. Initiative passes 3, starting next combat turn.
Alright.
So I'm 12.
You'll be tied with this guy.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So you resisted Drain?
Mm-hmm. I'm calculating.
Let me calculate for you.
No. Nah.
Recalculating.
Yep, I resist it.
Yeah, force 3, you resist it.
Yep.
Alright, starting next combat turn. Is that your thing?
Yeah, 12-3. Next combat turn.
Not initiative pass.
3 initiative passes.
Okay, so next combat turn, you get to do your thing.
Yeah.
But now, who got higher again? My character?
Yeah.
Second initiative pass. Let's do this. All
right. I have a second initiative pass, too.
We keep our same roll, right?
Hmm?
Nope, you make new rolls.
No, you keep the same roll.
Sorry, my bad. Though. Initiative passes, yeah, my bad.
Same
initiative.
Sorry, I thought you meant...
Characters attacking, yeah.
Hurry up and cut off somebody's head.
Okay.
He's attacking again. You managed to damage him enough that he got another layer of, negative was applied onto him.
Hey.
So yeah, that's why he's doing 14 this turn.
Okay.
1, 2. You only have to parry 2.
Okay, I'm gonna parry with my offhand weapon, and I'm gonna try and disarm him.
Can you do that? Can you do that?
He has to take a -1 if he doesn't have ambidextrous.
No, it's a -2.
-2.
But he's not only trying to block, he's trying to disarm.
Oh, disarm? That's a -4 on top of it.
Yeah.
So -6 if you're doing a disarm.
Yeah, but I'm using...
Do you have the disarm from the martial arts? Or are you just doing a natural one?
I have disarm as a martial art. So I can use a full parry with a -4 dice pool modifier. But since I'm using a full parry with my offhand weapon... And I have the 2 weapon style maneuver, then I still get my attack action with my other.
Let's see.
Kick his ass, man.
A full parry uses up your next action.
Not if I have the 2 weapon style and I'm only parrying with 1 weapon. With my offhand weapon.
2 weapon style doesn't make it where you can do 2 actions. It just makes it where you can attack 2 targets.
No. Just.
Oh, what martial arts? Which martial arts is it?
You split your dice to attack 1 target.
No, it's a maneuver. It's a 2 weapon style is a maneuver, and it says in the description the character.
That just adds.
The character may choose to apply the full defense option using only 1 of these weapons. Attacking with the other weapon as normal, and in brackets, and without sacrificing in action.
Oh, he's right.
So, here's...
Good thinking, Rook.
Yep.
Good dragon, good thinking. Holy shit! 19, wow.
You've... Dragon, you rolled that wrong. Did you take a -6?
Yeah. It's a full parry. So... So I apply my blade skill twice, right?
Oh, yeah.
7, I believe.
Yeah, you parry that.
fuck martial arts?
And is it my turn?
Yeah.
Oh, actually,
he not only parried, you just saw the katana fly away from the guy's hand. He just did one of those sword things where he does a little twist with the hand, and all of a sudden the other dude's sword just flies away.
All right.
And here's my attack action. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 hits.
Can he dodge this? I don't know.
Does he have an unarmed combat skill?
You want to know what's even better? His dodge. You want to know what specializes him?
Melee
combat. Unarmed combat.
Melee?
Melee combat.
Oh, yeah, melee. Yeah. Oh, okay. Then he can use that.
So his...
I could use that instead, and it won't use a full action.
Probably. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can.
Can I say something?
Mm-hmm.
Rook, you have pacifist 1. You just attacked an unarmed man.
Well, technically...
That may affect your pacifism.
I don't think it counts. I'm the one who disarmed him. Come on. And the attack happened right after.
I'm not going to get into this now. Now it's up to you and Cass to figure that out. I just put it out there.
I don't think that counts. Okay.
He's minor pacifist, right? Or is he major?
Minor,
yeah, he could do this since he's only doing stun. It wouldn't go against his will to knock. It wouldn't be that big of a thing
to knock out
his opponent.
He's just stunning. It's fine.
Yeah, he's just stunning. So.
Oh, I get a +1 die on card shots to disarm. I forgot about that. Oh well.
Now you know.
So that should have been a 20d6.
Oh, he passed out of the way.
1, 2, 3.
Another 11 stun.
11 stun.
Maybe this guy should give up.
I think you're supposed to roll body plus.
What am I supposed to roll?
Body plus impact armor.
Okay, so I'm rolling 17 dice again.
What the fuck? Is he a troll?
His armor's 12.
Does he have a body of 6?
The strange thing is, he's not taking any modifiers.
Wait.
Hold on.
Either Chalmers really fucked up this time, or something
weird. No, form-fitting bodysuit, I don't think, applies its weight as it should.
Oh, no, okay. You only do the modifiers. The -1 only starts when you're 2 points over. You're only 1 point over. My bad.
I was just half looking.
It's every 2 points over the limit, you add a -1. He's only 1 point over, so it doesn't come into act. That's why.
7. So you take another 4 stun damage, or?
Another 4.
Yep. So.
Okay, he's out. He's down.
Really?
Damn, he must have a willpower of nothing.
Oh. Cool.
No, he took 3 damage from your stun bolt. But as that happens. Something happens.
Mm-hmm.
Let me roll.
Someone starts doing the
Macarena.
Yeah. That's exactly what I was gonna say.
Some homeless guy just runs up out of an alley right in the middle of this fight and starts doing the Macarena.
1, 2, 3, 4. I can't even remember the song, but
it's in Spanish.
I used to know that song so much from rollerblading. The roller skating.
I remember when that song was playing constantly. I hated it.
Well, it was a fun thing to do while you were rollerblading. So.
They made us, at a school assembly back in elementary school, they made us all go down there and they said, oh, by the way, here's a Macarena thing. Everyone stand up and do the dance. What?
That's cruel and unusual.
Yeah.
So I have to do this. Two hits.
Were you rolling now?
You see the guy, miraculously, even though you think he's down. Something happens. You see the guy, even though you saw him knocked the hell out just a few seconds ago, he gets back up.
Okay.
It's not over yet.
Does he go Super Saiyan?
Wait, did he say it's not over yet?
Yeah.
I'm going to say good, because I was just about getting started.
Okay, he still has an initiative pass left.
He has 3 initiative passes.
Oh, yeah, he does.
Auto-injected with drugs.
You'd be surprised why I injected him with. I'll tell you after the session.
I know there's a couple drugs that I can think of that would do what you just did. Okay. So, I guess everyone rerolls initiative since it's the second turn, since the combat turns over.
It's not a combat. He still has one more pass left.
No, if he knocked out, it would come into effect next turn, not this turn.
All right.
Yeah. So, any changes to initiative come into effect next combat turn.
All right, so you now have 12 free.
Oh, no, we re-roll. My bad.
1, 2, 3. Add 3 to your 11. Is that 11 including your thing?
Yeah. Yep. 14-3.
That is 7 initiative.
Well, I have adrenaline surge, so I go first, and I'll just choose to wait and save it in case I want to interrupt.
Slash, what's his initiative?
I got 13 for my initiative.
He's currently suffering a -2 modifier.
I get to go first then.
Did you beat me? I had 14.
Oh, I had 13. I meant I go before this guy.
He's spending edge.
I'll spend an edge too.
Whatever, I'll leave it.
So that means who? I think the guy who goes first now.
Oh wait.
Who has the higher reaction?
Actually, you know what? I won't spend an edge. I can parry whatever he throws at me.
You're confident?
Sure. I want to see what he's got.
You're the samurai master.
Rejoiner.
Do you want to know what my parry is?
2.
Alright.
Is it 2?
No.
6 plus reaction, probably. Unless you actually have reflex recorder to add plus 1. I don't know if you're an adept or not, though.
Me?
Yeah.
No, I'm just a street samurai.
Knew it!
So, who goes first? I go first, or you go first?
You spent an edge, you go first.
There's actually drugs that do give an bonus agility.
Okay, but yep. Is he
isn't that cocaine?
4 or 5. Six.
He's not using the blood of Cali because he would have 4 initiative passes.
He's using cocaine.
4 or 5.
No, it's
so
not
that's
cocaine.
6 hits.
I think.
Okay.
No, wait, is he? Bath salts.
Is he punching me or something?
Oh crap, I forgot the sword got knocked out of your hands. Oh man. I guess
he... Maybe he's on bath salts.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. He's punching me, right?
I should have rolled just massive to get his sword back first. But that would have been a simple action or complex, depending on what I say. I would say it's complex, so I should have rolled gymnastics. Okay, ignore that roll.
Alright.
What are you trying to do, Quaz?
I thought I had my sword on me, but I didn't.
So are you doing an unarmed attack, or are you going to pick up the sword?
I'm going to go pick up the sword, so that's going to be a full action.
Yeah, that's because you're using a simple... You're going to be running simple action to pick it up. You're not, and you can't end up attacking because you don't have a complex action. So yeah. Your turn is picking up the sword.
Do I still need to roll gymnastics?
I don't think so. It's pretty... I mean, it depends where the sword was, and since you didn't detail it out or anything, I'm assuming the sword's not in between you and Quaz.
Is he Fern?
And Quaz didn't save up an inter... Quaz couldn't have saved up an interrupt action anyway. So, yeah, you're fine. You can go get the sword.
Is he far enough away that I can charge him?
Yes.
Actually, yeah, he is, I think. Because you only need, what, 1 meter for a charge?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can charge.
Okay, so that's 20d6 to hit. And here it comes. So, yeah.
How many hits do you got?
Oh, my bad.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can I spend an edge to reroll any misses?
Why? Oh, yeah, you can reroll it. Go ahead.
Oh. So I only...
You can spend an edge to reroll all your misses. Yeah.
Okay, and yeah. I got 5 hits so far, right?
Yeah, we gotta start finishing up combat, because at
10:50,
I have to absolutely end this.
6 plus 5, that's 11 hits.
11 hits.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 12 hits, sorry.
Man, you're like a brick tree. Alright, so. So I'm going to be rolling. Wait, I have my sword in my hand. Could I do something?
You can do a parry. Or a full parry.
I can't do a simple?
What do you mean a simple? You can do a simple if you want to. Did you add the negatives?
Which negatives do I need to add?
The negative 2 from damage.
Yeah, about that.
So, 13 stun damage, or... Wait, I'm guessing that drug thing...
You're still doing 13 stun damage. If he doesn't resist this, he might not resist this with impact armor. There's still a chance you could just knock him out.
Okay. Because I'm guessing that drug thing allows him to ignore the modifiers or something.
He's heavily medicated. He might crash.
Probably it's one of the ones that does pain, adds you the pain tolerance, which I think can only go up to 6. So if you do 6 stun, you should not come back out again.
Okay.
Unless he's on bath salt, then he ain't going down.
Then again, I could have created my own drugs.
Like bath salts?
Really? You know...
That's why I spent a part of the week on.
He injected the super serum.
No, if I did the super serum, he would basically get more to his physical.
Captain Yakuza.
That's it.
No, Cass, really, bath salt. It's essentially meth and cocaine mixed together.
If my character, the professor, comes in, I'm using the chemistry skill to make my own drugs.
Yes. Yes. It'll be glorious making crystal meth of you.
Oh, can you make me a super serum?
You shall make all the crystal meth ever, and then poison it so you can kill random addicts.
Hey, can you?
Yeah, you really.
You probably make things with like ratings, like giving me more than I would right now.
Yeah, I'm because the professor has the first aid, the medicine skill, and the chemistry skill.
You want to poison crystal meth? Just pee on it.
And for some reason, I also have the cyberware skill for implanting cyberware, just because I felt like
it. Hey. Does that also work on BioWare?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I think so.
Awesome.
It's cyber technology. I don't know if it does both. I'm checking.
The worst part of this drug is it lowers your body by 2.
I see.
So that's why he has 15 D6.
Okay.
Manga, click it.
Oh. Sorry, I was looking up something.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Cyber technology is for both cybernetics and BioWare.
Oh, okay.
I'm the mad scientist type of doctor. Actually, I'm not really a doctor. That's why I say I'm the professor. I just have medical skills because I can do evil things with them.
I think I did 7 stun damage to him.
7 stun damage.
1, 2.
He's barely going. Just barely.
Manga, did you lose your medical license?
Yeah.
He's barely up and running at this point.
Like I said, I'm the professor. I'm not the doctor. I'm the professor.
I'm just going to roll his willpower to see if he could stay up.
Okay.
That's because if you know, you watch the TF2 stuff.
No, he's not. Even though he got one hit, he's not up. He's down.
Yay.
If he had gotten free hits, he would be up.
That's his willpower? Okay.
Yeah.
Modified. Oh, okay.
Not modified. The drug doesn't modify willpower.
That's better willpower than mine.
Oh, I was talking about the damage. -2 to all actions, or maybe -3 at this point.
Yeah, after he did all the actions, -3, but the thing is, that drug actually did it, so...
Oh, okay.
Although you do see, like, you knocked him out with your sword, but you do see more Yakuza cards park up, but as they do that, I actually have to look up the car in my notes. Hold on a second.
Let's say the Batmobile.
I'm taking it. It's the Batmobile, I'm going to take it.
You see, I have to look up the book now. I don't remember what it looks like.
If I remember right, the Batmobile is actually in Used Car Lot.
Oh, yeah.
There is a vehicle that looks like it, yeah.
I need Used Batmobile. Car Lot again. Because I love Used Car Lot.
Mm-hmm.
Wait. Which Batmobile? The Adam West Mobile?
It's not the Batmobile. It's just there's a vehicle in Used Car Lot that looks a lot like a Batmobile.
Okay, I'm saying it looks like which one, because there's been a bunch of them. It's like does it look like the Adam West Mobile?
All right, you see,
it's probably the more traditional cartoon one. It's been a while since I've looked at it.
All right, fair enough.
You see a... Yeah, you see a...
The Oscar Mayer weenie wagon.
That would be hilarious if that was true.
If any other cars are gonna come, I'm gonna throw a smoke grenade.
No, this is before you do that. Before you do that... You actually see a Devil Rat come up and start shooting the absolute fuck out of the cars, causing them to go backwards. Causing them both to go backwards.
Okay.
Then you see Max pop out of the hatch.
Of the Devil Rat?
Yep, the back crew hatch.
Okay.
Oh, fine work. Ah, I'm sorry about the Yakuza thing.
Yakuza thing?
I'm sorry about the Yakuza
thing. I go to one of the down guys with the silence assault rifles and loot it.
I'm going to steal the Yakuza guy's sword.
Okay, you steal his sword. Doesn't have anything on it, fancy on it, just has a thing. When you try to steal that thing, are you going to test fire it?
What?
When you steal his gun, are you going to test fire it?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, alright.
Take their comm links.
You didn't... How would I do this, son? You should probably fire it.
Actually,
I says you should probably fire it. The Yakuza are enabling advanced safety system.
Doesn't matter. I can still palm it.
Yeah, you can still steal it.
The Metal Gear Solid 2 type of advanced safety system, where it locks with the biometrics of a soldier, so other
if
people can't pick up and use it.
Depends on how he took the gun, whether or not. I mean, sure, the gun will probably lock up, and that's nice and everything, but he can eventually, if he takes it, he can sell it, or he can get someone to hack into it to change it.
Aye.
Yeah, we can have Jay do that during the week.
Yeah. And those are both options. It's not that big of a deal for him to steal it. As long as it wasn't the anti-shock.
Yeah, that stuff's just so if you drop it in the middle of combat, somebody doesn't run up and grab it and shoot you.
Yeah. Because, I mean, there's different anti-thefts. So.
So.
All right, moving on. Combat is away. Over.
Okay, so you guys get paid, what, 75,000 divided?
18,750.
Wait, we weren't told about this, Yakuza. We were under the impression that this was an easy job.
Yeah, I never expected Yakuza either. Apparently, from what I could tell, these guys were cleaning up the elves upstairs. From what I could tell.
How much are their heads worth?
The Yakuza, I'm just going to give you each 10,000, 5,000K for just dealing with this. Each.
So, 5,000K each on top?
5,000K each on top.
Okay.
So, how much is that in total for each of us?
23,750.
23,750.
I got 75,000 divided by 4 is 18,750 plus the 5,000. I have to add that.
Yay.
Is 23,750.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm sorry I have to end this so
quick.
Oddly
enough, we've completed more missions in your campaign, Quaz, than we did in the Lagos campaign. Mm. What was the karma?
I'm going to say it's 7.
7? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Guys, don't forget something.
Oh, yeah! One more thing before I leave. Manga, are you going back to your car, or you going for a ride?
I was still in my car.
You go into your car. You notice your car starts moving.
Uh-huh. I was in my car the whole time, you know.
I thought you were, like, on a rooftop.
No, I just had my car parked in a good position.
You said rooftop.
I never said rooftop for this one. I said I was in a good position where I could see within my car.
So I can.
I never said this time rooftop.
I can use karma to.
Still see your car move.
I can use.
You see your car move? It seems to be leading you somewhere.
I would like to point out that Jay's character never heard me call him a bitch hacker. I was never told that.
You left him there.
Yeah, true.
The car eventually goes back to the thing.
Oh, wait. Was this the right car or wasn't this?
Thing? What?
Goes back to the warehouse where you first met Matt.
I guess I'll get in the white delivery van.
So you guys get paid and everything else. Unfortunately, I have to end it here because I sort of have to go to bed. So.
Whiskey, did you roll for my car to detect him?
Yeah, I did. It failed.
Hey,
yeah,
I can use karma to get a new contact, right?
I normally like people to get contacts with karma and improve them. No, not karma. Get contacts through roleplay and improve them through roleplaying. So
yeah, that's how I usually do contacts too.
Okay.
Is role-playing.
Because I actually...
Quiz Cake, one question. Since you rescinded the 2BP or the 2 restriction, does that turn into karma for this character, or is that just gone?
That turns into karma. I'm not going to be that evil.
Okay, it's just that I sort of came up with an idea for a new contact, so...
Alright.
You know how he escaped from... My character escaped from a... facility, right? And there are other escapees too, so I was figuring he met up with one of them. Like, I'm...
Your bunk buddy?
Oh, yeah. During the week, each of you, whoever's currently on, each of you are probably going to receive a call from me. Dragon, yours is probably going to be from there. Jay, you're actually going to be meeting... Max says he could actually have you meet with a hacker if you wanted anything else, or because the hacker wanted to talk to you.
Well, maybe. Probably.
And Manga, there's someone specific who wants to visit you.
Huh?
There's someone specific who wants to visit your character.
Okay.
So I'll have them do that during the week. So, other than that, I'm just going to end it here. Good night, guys.
Good night. Good night.